According to data from CryptoCompare, at 3:15 UTC on Sunday, February 9, the Bitcoin price surged past $1,000, for the first time since 22 September 2019, as you can see from the six-month price chart shown below. Since then, the price rally has continued, and at press time, Bitcoin is trading at $1,000, up almost 3% in the past 24-hour period. Here is what popular crypto analyst slash trader Willy Wu, who is a partner at crypto hedge fund Adaptive Capital, had to say about this breakout. This breakout is the real deal.
Fundamental investment activity is backing this $10K breakout.
Fick, Twitter, com/idamixmygs, Willy Wu, at Wunomic, February 9, 2020. Bitcoin's market cap currently stands at $184.26 billion, and its price has gone up an impressive 40.82% so far in 2020.
Is this due to people buying Bitcoin as a hedge against the risks of the novel coronavirus outbreak or fear of missing out, FOMO, due to the upcoming Bitcoin block reward halving, or both?
Although it is impossible to say with certainty which of these two factors, if any, has had the most influence on the price of Bitcoin, it is undeniable that the daily reports out of China about the effects of the outbreak on the Chinese economy, as the result of temporary closure of shops/factories and offices, paints quite a bleak picture not just for the Chinese economy but the world economy.
Here are a couple of examples of how businesses in China are suffering as the result of this epidemic. On Friday, February 7, Bloomberg reported that Apple is extending the closure of most of its retail stores until February 15.
Also, this weekend, we found out on Saturday, February 8, that Chinese multinational conglomerate Tencent Holdings Limited is keeping its offices closed until February 24, and possibly later. Update: Tencent further extended to February 24. The epidemic is far from being contained at this point now, it is a full month without any income for most companies.
Millions of SMEM, who are with little cash reserve, will have to lay off, eventually close out in following weeks. At Davewan, February 8, 2020, on the same day, Davewan, who is a founding partner of blockchain-focused venture investment firm Primitive Ventures, also pointed out that if China becomes economically crippled, this could potentially also hurt the economies of all countries. So sick of the overblown hostile tone. The fact is, if China is really sick economically and dragged into depression, the world will be crippled too. Pick Twitter.com/OpenRoastDevay. 1. At Davewan, February 8, 2020. So, it would sense if some people in China and elsewhere were buying gold and/or Bitcoin as stores of value to hedge against potential crashes in the world's bond and stock markets, even though, thankfully, the U.S. markets have been left relatively unscathed by what is happening. You can read full post on CryptoFans News, link available in text below.